Hi kids, I hope that you all had a wonderful week. I want to remind all of you that we have our Sunday school lessons for grades pre-K through sixth grade, the paper copies available here in each entrance of the church and as well as online. There is also lessons online from Mr. Charvin, Mr. Rick, and Miss Caitlin, and that is for age 2 all the way up through fourth grade. So you may access those online. It's a live video that they've recorded. So I want to read to you again today. And I just also want to bring to your attention that there are amazing books in our church library here. And we also have puzzles. So you are welcome to stop by with your families and pick up some books and some puzzles. I'm going to read to you, it's called Reuben and the Blizzard. It was the day before the snow came. Reuben was in the barn trying to decide what to name the 5 new puppies when his grandfather shuffled in. Dottie loved puppies as much as he did. They all look like their mother, Dottie said. And it was true. The tiny pups snuggled up against Spotshine, cozy and half asleep, paying as little attention to Reuben as his 5 sisters did. The next day at school, everyone was talking about the snow, as though it were a sure thing. Sam and Ben leaned against the fence during recess, telling Reuben how their dad said it might be a blizzard. Then the teacher rang the bell, and Reuben and the twins headed back to the schoolroom. "Did you name those pups yet?" Sam asked. "It's a secret," Reuben smiled, and they all laughed because they knew that meant Reuben hadn't been able to decide on 5 new names ending in shine. He always named his animals that way. Reuben's younger sister, Sadie, was up front reciting a poem when Reuben saw the first snowflake. The wind was blowing hard, and he knew the walk home from school would be a cold one. By the time they had finished the chores, snow covered the ground. Reuben couldn't even tell where the yard stopped and started. The snow piled up like layers of thick white icing across their farm. Ma'am and Reuben's sister Mary had fixed a special supper for Dottie's birthday. Ham loaf and buttered noodles, angel food cake, and homemade chocolate ice cream. Sounds delicious. Dottie smiled a lot and told stories about the old days when snow was 2 feet deep. "It doesn't snow like it used to," Dottie said. "We used to hitch our horses to the sleigh every winter." Reuben could hardly remember ever riding in a sleigh. Before they went to bed, Reuben and Dot bundled up in their heavy coats and boots and headed out to the barn to check the animals. The cows were asleep, and so were the calves, and all looking peaceful in their warm straw. Spotshine and her puppy slept too, looking like a family dat, smiled at Reuben and winked. "Do they know their names yet?" he asked. Reuben smiled back through the heavy scarf wrapped around his neck. "If they do, it's a secret," he said. Dot laughed softly so as not to waken the puppies. Cute little puppies. When Reuben came down to the kitchen in the morning, he could barely see the barn. The snow was falling so fast. Dot was out in the howling wind and cold, trying to shovel a path to the cow stable. Dottie burst into the kitchen from his end of the house, his eyes big and his voice stronger than usual. "This is like the old days," he said to Ma'am by the warm cook stove. Excitement spilled from his voice, the way it had on the day the puppies were born. It snowed all day, the wind whipping white dunes all over the farm and around the buildings. Reuben went to the barn to help with the animals, but he had to take his older sister Annie's hand so he wouldn't get lost in the storm. When they left the house, they couldn't even see the barn. The snow was so thick in the air. But Annie knew her directions, and a few minutes later they walked against the side of the barn. They followed the wall to the door and stepped into the warm, friendly stable. "It's the worst snowstorm I've ever seen," Dot said. "I hope we don't have to pour the milk away." Reuben hadn't stopped to think about what they'd do if the truck from the dairy couldn't get there to pick up the milk. No one liked to waste milk. Spotshine was glad to see Reuben, but the pups were busy having breakfast, drinking milk from their mother. Then the wind stopped, the sun came out, and no more snow fell. Reuben stood by the barn door and looked at the mountains of snow everywhere. He could see Dottie by the kitchen window, looking out, his eyes big. They waved to each other and laughed. "What a blizzard," Dad said. "That has to be more than 2 feet deep." Reuben knew some of the snowdrifts were higher than his head. Some of you may be wishing that we have a snow that big sometime. Reuben and all five of his sisters helped their father shovel snow. All day, even Mam came out with an old broom. Dottie wanted to help, but Dad said it wasn't good for his heart. The roads were closed. The neighbors could not even drive their cars. "It looks like the electric lines are down," Annie said. "I suppose everyone's out of electricity." But it didn't matter to Reuben's family because they didn't use electricity. "Sometimes our way has advantages," Mam smiled. They were eating a late lunch when Reuben heard a loud knock at their door. It was Lester the Pester from down the road. People called him the Pester, Mam used to say, because he played tricks on people. Lester was worried. His wife Lily was having a baby and needed to get to the hospital, but the roads were closed and Lester couldn't use his car. "We'll get out the sleigh," Dad said. Reuben's heart jumped up and down. He looked at his father with his question, afraid he'd say no. "If your mother agrees," Dad said. Lester the Pester fidgeted by the door as everyone looked at Mam. Finally, she smiled. "You can go along, Reuben," she said, "if you dress warmly and be careful." He leaped from the table and went to get his heavy coat. The sleigh skimmed across the snow like a sled, the horses up ahead trotting across the fields between the drifts. It was great fun. Lester even laughed. "I can never thank you enough," he said. "I was so worried we couldn't get help." "Glad to help," Dad said. Reuben waved at Sam and Ben as the sleigh cut across their fields to Lester and Lily's house. They were finishing two huge snowmen. "Look at those snowmen," Lester pointed. "They look like twins." They helped Lily into the sleigh carefully. Then the four of them headed for the main road near town. It was very cold. The sun was setting, throwing light as bright as fire across the frozen snow. The ambulance met them at the main road. "You did a good thing," the ambulance man with the funny glasses told Dad. Lily and Lester thanked them again before the ambulance rushed them away to the hospital. Reuben found his sister Sadie looking at the pups when he got home. Spotshine licked Reuben's hand as he picked up the pup with a white patch above its nose. "How are you, Snowshine?" he asked. Sadie giggled. "May I name one?" she begged. "Or are they all named already?" "This one's Frosty Shine," he said. "And these two are White Shine and Bright Shine." "And what about the last one?" Sadie asked. "I wasn't sure." "How about Icing Shine?" Sadie suggested. Icing Shine? Yeah. I thought the snow looked like thick, yummy icing." Reuben nodded, and Sadie giggled as she held the pup against her cheek. That night, they had the best sledding Reuben could remember. He and Sadie raced their sleds down the hill behind the barn. Soon, his older sisters came out too, laughing and squealing as they whizzed down the snow tracks. But what Reuben always remembers about the blizzard was Dottie on the sled. Dottie said he wanted one big ride, so he and Reuben piled on the sled together. Dottie's beard blowing and Reuben laughing. It was such fun. As good as the old days, Reuben guessed. The cold in their faces, everything white, and a ride as fast as the silent wind down the long frozen hill. The two of them together. weekend. I hope you enjoyed the story. And as the snow we got yesterday was very beautiful. It might not have been as big as the ones they're talking about here, but it was certainly beautiful. I hope you have a wonderful new year, and I look forward to seeing you.